员的经验。那我们在这个 Slido 上已经有一些提问了，那我们会留到等一下的 discussion 跟 Q&A 的时间。
So thank you, Chairman Chen, for the sharing. And we've already receiving some questions from the audience in the silo. So perhaps in the few, later on, we can talk more regarding the issues raised.
那如果比较晚来的朋友的话，可以到就是 sli.do 上面打入今天的日期是20180421，可以从上面提问。
And those who are just arrived at the venue, you can, if you have questions, you can go to the website silo.do/ with the time today, 2018,
04/21. 好，接着我们很荣幸邀请到这个他是一位社会学的教授Dominic。来跟我们分享我们所知道民主的不同的形式，以及在法国有一些 CivTech 的 project， 在这三个不同民主形式上面的一些的一些应用跟实例。
Next, let us welcome Dominic. He is a sociologist, and also today he will share with us the three different forms of democracy and the devices and tools of CivTech.Utilized in France regarding the three different fields of democracy. Let us welcome.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here. It's a pleasure to have those kind of visits and discussion with everyone here. It's a very great opportunity for us to have all those kind of.Experience that we could share.
那就是非常开心，就是跟大家在这一连串下来跟大家交流，然后分享这些经验和互相的学习。
As I am a sociologist, I can't present use case without having a kind of theoretical framework. So I will give you in a very short time a very simple and naive framework.And then after, I will try to describe three French experiences that are in relation to this framework.
那作为一个社会学家，免不了就是有时候还是会用一个算比较天真的一种政治的框架来去看待一些事情啊。那接下来我就会稍微跟大家解释一下这个框架，同时跟大家分享一下三个我们在法国的经验。
So it's a very naive idea, but the question that I want to suggest is that we don't have a real definition of democracy because we have a very, very broad definition of democracy and very restrictive definition of democracy.
那当然在民主这边的话，其实我们会分享的比较是单纯和原初，或者是比较天真的一个定义。那这个定义的部分，其实可以从非常严谨的定义到比较宽松的定义。
In fact, democracy can be a lot of different things. It's at first its election to design representatives. It's also something that is a social movement, social protest. It's also something that is linked to NGOs and associations that we call civil society.It also media on public space, and it's also the kind of things that we could say that democracy of the ordinary life, of the relationship inside the family, inside at work, or in different situation of the ordinary life.
那当然从最严谨的定义的话，就是像选举这种代议式民主的一种表现的形式哦。那到后面就是可能一些社会的运动啊，社会的一些示威游行的部分，或者是到我们在结社一些活动和公民社会的一些参与，或者是到在媒体上面对于公共空间的一些讨论，到最宽广的部分就是像我们日常生活中，不管是在家庭里面，或者是在工作上面各个面向里面的一种民主的体现。
That's the reason why in the kind of the reflection that I have on the relationship between digital tools and democracy, I think it's useful to have three different shape or definition of democracy. The first is coming from the idea that if we take the large space of democracy, we have the very traditional definition of democracy, and sometimes we say that representative democracy is democracy. We have a lot of theory saying that no, it's only one possibility of democracy, that is the idea to elect representative with representative democracy.
当然在讲到说数位工具跟民主之间的一些互动跟结合的话，我们就会可以看到就是像这样子的一个圆圈跟范围的一些讨论。那这个在这个范围里面，就是所谓民主这个范围里面，其实第一个可以讲到就是代议式的民主。那在这里面，很多人常常都说代议式民主就是民主，也是民主唯一可能的一种形式，就是选出我们的代议士来进行。
But if we keep the idea that we have a larger democracy, we have something else which is not in representative democracy, that we could call public space, civil society, or with digital tools, I call this kind of new dimension of democracy, internet democracy, because internet gives digital tools give people way to empower themselves, to connect themselves, and to connect individuals with no direct relation with representative democracy. So my second definition is the idea that we could have something like an internet democracy.
那另外的话，就是除了代议式的民主以外，我们其实也可以就是，比如说像这种公共空间或公民社会那种。借用工具或者是数位科技的一些方式来互相彼此的连接。那在连接的同时的时候，不一定是需要会到我们的代议式民主这边去连接在一起。那我称之为就是算网路式的民主。
And the third one is the idea to articulate the true representative and internet democracy to have a kind of participatory democracy where connected people could discuss, suggest, propose information and participate to the decision process of representative democracy.
那在另外一种的话，就是所谓参与式的民主。那这些人他可以去参与到特定历程的决策过程的一些，不管专案的一些过程的决策或讨论，或是甚至进到我们算是议会算讨论里面的一些参与之中。
So I think it's really interesting, for me it's interesting. It's interesting to have those three different ideas of where digital tools could help different forms of democracy. And I will try to give three examples of open data or civic tech movements that are linked to those three different forms of democracy.
那当然我觉得就我本身当然他觉得说这是很有趣的一个分析。那接下来当然也可以去看到说我们数位工具可以怎么样去应用到这三种不同类型的民主的形式上面。
So the three we have I took just three French situations, French civic tech that play an important role in theSmall space of civic tech, but were very famous for their project, for their idea, and who have a lot of communication about them. The first one has been produced by a very small but very active and very old in the history of the French civic tech, which is called Regard Citoyen, Citizen Look, and it produced something that they produce a website.And the name of the website is nodeputy.fr or deputy.fr.
那接下来的话，当然，虽然说我们法国这边在数位科技应用到我们民主政治场域的话，其实不算是很大或是很有名。在公民科技里面，虽然我们很小，但是我们都有很多像比较有趣的一些东西和一些应用。那可以看到的就是像这样子的一个平台。
The idea is clearly to improve or enhance representative democracy, to help citizens to have more information with more kind of transparency about the daily activities of deputies and senators in France because they crawl the data coming from the website of the assembly or the document, or PDF document of the assembly, just in order to show for each member of the parliament to know if it what kind of job does he produce inside the parliament, what kind of meetings do is he present during the assembly meeting, what does he vote for different law, what kind of amendment could he that he has proposed during the process of making the, of the law. And all those information has been gathered just in order to have the kind of visualization of each parliamentary members of the assembly.
这个平台的话，其实就是算帮助有助于我们大英式民主的一种体现了。就是你可以在上面看得到，当然我们有很多在网络上，你可以都可以看得到议会里面的一些相关的法案啊、修正案的一些资料。那可能是 PDF 或是其他的形式，种种。但是我们就是把它汇集起来，包含它在哪些议员，它在议会里面它提出哪些法案，讨论了什么，甚至是他投票的部分，他是投哪一部分，这些相关的资讯我们整合，然后用一种视觉化的呈现，然后分享给公众。
So it's one of the most interesting and most famous civic tech in France because it creates a kind of reflexive loop between parliamentary members, journalists, and citizens. Because as soon as citizens discover thatSome of the deputies don't work a lot, are not very well ranked inside the different list of members of the parliament. Parliamentary members began to change their behavior, began to criticize the way data has been produced and to say it's not the best way to represent the activity of a member of the parliament because sometimes data are just silly.So we need to find other way to represent the activity of parliamentary member. But other members of parliament try to change their behavior. So we have this kind of very, let's say, virtuous circle that could be, that have been set up because of the nodeputé.fr roles inside the public, French public space. I need to say that journalists play a very important role because journalists use a lot this kind of information to write their articles.
那这样子的资讯的话，其实在不管是在我们的议员这边，或者是记者，还有就是民众之间，算是出现一个反思的一些循环跟思考当中。那当然有些议员他可能会去批判说，这样子的资讯他这样的指标是不够能够完真实去反映出他在议会里面的表现种种。但是他们也因为这些资料的出现，然后开始去改变他行为上面的一些部分。那同时当然所以可以说是已经创造出算一种正向的循环。那其中非常重要就是像记者他们会大量去参考我们提供的这样的资料，那他常常就会借由这样资料去撰写他们的报道。
I need to say that the same collective Regard Citoyen also produce another website. I need to say it because it has been produced with my lab, research lab, Media Lab. And they produce a new website with Civic Tech, which is called The Making of the Law, La Fabrique de la Loi. And it helps citizens, researchers, and journalists to go inside the way law is produced, title by title, chapter by chapter, article by article, with amendment, and you can know.What is the discussion about the amendment that has been produced and who vote for or against this amendment? It's a kind of zoom that can help us to explore the making of the law.
那除了刚才我们有提到像 Regard Citoyen 这样的平台，那另外当然就是我刚才我自己本身的 Media Lab，还有另外一个比较有趣的，像是这上面的算是法案制定的一个网站，在上面网址这边，你可以进去到这边，然后去看到 法案推动的一个过程，不管是它逐条的一些审查的部分，或者是它的一些什么修正有提出，你都可以在这上面一个一个看到这个法案它推动跟制定的过程。
My second use case is a link to participatory democracy. The idea is different, very different in fact. It's to help representative and parliamentary member to discuss with citizens when they are producing a new law. We have some good and bad experiences on this question in France. And we could be very critics on some of them. But one of them were quite interesting, and we were quite surprised of the result of this discussion. The law has been launched by Axel Lemaire, and it's a law about the digital republic, concerning, among different things, open data. And the law has been discussed by 20,000 contributors. It's not a lot, but it's something. And part of the contribution were really interesting. People could produce comments, they could suggest new articles or new amendments, and they could also vote for the amendments or proposals that have been produced by other internet users.
另外的话就是可以看到像这样子就是Lemaire 这个平台，这个、上面的话，其实它是帮助所谓的参与式民主这个形式的一个沟通，其实跟刚才的一个工具是相当不一样。它可以帮助我们的议会的代表去了解说他民众他的心声，还有他的沟通跟他们之间的沟通。那在这上面的话，其实你可以看得到，就是其实它有大概20,000个。人在上面贡献他们的意见，不管是在批评啊，或者是提案，或者是投票，虽然不多，但是有很多很有趣的。那他们提的时候是甚至可以去提一些算是法案或者修正案的部分，那投票也可以针对这些相关的法案跟修正案来进行投票。
Among the 20,000 contributions that have been produced,civil servant and administration that tried to have a very close look at the argumentation proposals that have been done in the process of participatory democracy recorded 8,000 arguments that could be addressed and could be discussed by the administration and the parliamentary for the discussion. So we have a real discussion on some of the arguments whereimportant and have been written in the discussion inside the parliament. Some other proposals have been dropped off the discussion, and it was also a very political and huge debate because part of the proposals that have been suggested by internet have not been written by the cultural industry and part of the government that defend intellectual property, and this part of the text was not discussed in the parliament. So let's say we have a kind of mitigated result of this consultation. Some parts were very interesting, and for other parts there were a lot of critics about the way the participatory process has been conducted.
那在将近就是20,000个一些贡献的的一些量上面的话，大概有8,000个其实是可以作为不管是政府的官员或是议会的代表们去思考，甚至去讨论，甚至已经可以去想办法去提案的。那其实其中有不乏很多其实已经是写到正式议会讨论的一些文件当中，那当然也有一些就是可能一些政治的一些考量，或是在一些运作当中而因此掉出来了。那当然在这过程中也有一些人去批判和反思说，这样子参与式的民主这样的互动的形式到底是不是真的有效，或者是它这有什么样的问题，其实也很多人都在思考。
Just to conclude with the third definition that I've tried to give of democracy. We also have a kind of Occupy movement in France. Some part of the movement could be compared to sunflower movement, but there are so many cultural and political differences that appears. And this kind of movement produced something which is directly linked to my idea of internet democracy. It was people suggesting, producing opinion, connecting together, and creating large part of large files of data that are also a kind of public production of data produced by citizens on a very strange wiki, which is Nuit Debout Wiki. I don't know how to translate Nuit Debout, night, stand up night, I don't know how to translate that. And they create, they occupy the place de la, the place of Republic, which is one of the most important place in Paris, during 3 months. They discuss every night, every evening and every night, and they create 64 commissions. Inside each commission, there were from five to ten sub-commissions. Each sub-commission discuss about the rules of the discussion, discuss about the procedure of democracy, and made a lot of suggestions. Sometimes it's very difficult to have a political interpretation of what they try to say inside this movement, but it's a huge data set of public data produced by citizens in the context of internet democracy.
那第三种的话，就是第三种民主形式，其实就是你可以看到，像可能像有点像是占领。占领运动这样子的活动，像太阳花这样子，有很多雷同之处，那都是由公众和民众他们自发性的去发声，然后去串联在一起，那同时就是展现出他们的意见这样子，那在全法国来进行，那其中的话，其实可以看到像这个 Nuit Debout这样子算危机的条目，其实当初我们在巴黎那边，我们占领了一个非常重要的一个广场，那在上边长达3个月，然后在这期间当中，我们有64个算一个委员会，然后不断的针对问号题目去讨论，那所有的讨论的资料，我们都是透过这样子的危机的方式去整理出来。那有些当然或许可以有用，那有些当然也会有些人当然会觉得说可能要怎么样把它转换到政治上面的一个讨论，或者是他们东西到底有没有什么比较具体的一个聚焦的部分，当然也是会有这样的情形之间，但是这是我们一种所谓网络式民主的一种表现形式之一。
So representative democracyParticipative democracy, internet democracy, regard citoyen, Loi Lemaire, Nuit Debout, it's three different civic tech, it's three different ways to use data, it's three different ways to articulate administration, government, citizen, and data. And I think that when we have to explore the different forms of the open data and civic tech movement, we need to consider the various ways that we could use data to produce citizenship. Thank you.
那当然，以上的话就是我跟大家介绍，不管是所谓的代议式民主、参与式民主，或是网络式的民主，然后三大平台，从那个Citoyen 到 Nuit Debout 这些平台，我们都可以怎么样去产生和搜集这样子的开放的资料。然后后续我们也可以好好思考说怎么样再进行利用这样子开放的资料去做去形塑我们算是公民的社会它的一种关系。那以上跟大家分享到这边，谢谢。